Welcome everyone to another fun little maybe educational piece 3 live stream here. I spent here already some minutes before the live stream, actually also previous video I actually also finished here the FPGA goodness, so 32-bit even in GitHub anyway. But back to the PS3 stuff, I wanted the next ISO, and this stream is actually not only PS3 related, because this is also generic T2 stuff, ever-changing Linux stuff. So for a new ISO, that's probably also affecting all other architectures. I just realized building here's the image. We have, as usual, a couple of small Linux snafus. One is, I just realized some packages don't have all the files in them. We use this FLIST tracking shared library stuff. Yeah, welcome everyone. The title, although we're creating a new ISO, this will be not the most P3 specific, also a lot of Linux fun. So why some packages we use this FList wrapper, this sandboxing stuff, to track the installed files. And apparently I tracked this already, as you see, otherwise. So not only did I test this on the PS3, but also I debugged this a little bit already, and then I realized, okay, maybe it's worse to start a live stream. Actually the last hour here without a live stream. Anyway, so what is new here? Why this file is, I guess, not in this archive, is that it's using a new system call rename @2 here to rename this bin temp file here, as probably somewhat visible. So also, if you're new to this channel, so not only P3 and sjoctane, but also all kinds of Linux goodness, low level stuff. So the system calls, of course, what a user program, as your game or even a shell or anything, is calling the kernel with a system call for open, like open a file, like similar to our previous video, FPGA RISC-V goodness. So open a file, this is a system call, open, read, write, close, and ioctl, and rename, and unlink for delete. So this, and new in Linux land, are new system calls, many of those system calls with @. So we had here just rename @. Actually did not check. So as we run this system call, and it's not in the modified file. So what this @ is doing is, all the classic system calls have source and destination or similar stuff, and they're always either absolute paths or relative to the current working directory. And for many high performance applications, it's actually often another referencing directory. So all those @ system calls are referencing at another file descriptor. So this is, here is this current working directory, but it could also be @. It's a little bit hilarious that in many cases, I've rarely seen this used. So many libraries and applications use this new system calls, just passing in some additional argument like @ current working directory. Like, yeah, thank you very much for this. You could have used also the old system call, but whatever. So basically in Linux, also many system calls exist two times. So this is one of the reasons why we don't have some of the files in here. And anyway, we had this to modify this FL wrapper. We have here misc shared, where do we have misc source something, FL. So we have the wrapper sources here somewhere of wrapper. And a long story short already, before everyone tunes out, let's go on. Wrapper.c. It's a whole lot of maintenance stuff. Somehow this is also not the right file here. FL wrapper something CSH. And as you see, it's a lot of maintenance overhead of just ever-changing stuff. So just like want to continue with RSX, but yeah, this is broken. UDIF update, packages don't have all the files. Welcome everyone. Also Andreas Baumann is here, glibc231, libseccop, and fakeroot systemd. Something might not agree on system calls, especially on non-64-bit. Yeah, Thank you very much for this heads up. I'm actually, so do we have rename? We have, yeah. So this is already what I expected. We have rename, but not rename add. Probably I've never seen it used before. So we need to add this. I forgot already. So as you see, we generate here source code because this is highly repetitive. So we use shell code to generate all the wrapping stuff here. So this is run in the shell code to generate C. This is compiled and then FL preloaded. Here I just need to remember how was this. Let's take a look. So this is in symlink, so most likely we probably should check this with min rename add. And so this is old something. Where is, why is this, wait a second, rename add, why is this int old? Ah, okay, wait a second. So this is, ah, darn it, has even two add pointers, darn it. Ah, so yeah, but anyway, as you see, so this is, if you compare this to rename or any other, I also rename, what was it, three or two or, so rename is just old path, new path, and all the new add system calls of all the other, also open add, min to open, in terms of just open something, and the new open add, another directory file descriptor to reference this from. So let's see, we have here, also this is probably, this was a return then, so most likely versus with a symlink. Let's double check this with what was the other, this was it symlink at symlink at, but it becomes increasingly convoluted and error prone. And also if we use another more modern, more sophisticated sandboxing technology, it would have happened the same. If you don't have a new system call in there, then it certainly doesn't work. So old parse, new directory fd, so symlink add. So yeah, here this is a directory. Let's see, I'm actually not sure if this automatically will work. So rename add, so this was fun. It's so much to talking you all the details, and rename add. So fd parse, so int parse source int. I'm just not sure whether we have here some automagic for, I've actually, so even I look only every 5 years into this. Let's see what happens, I've no idea. It could totally blow up. The problem is, what have we done now? Also error, unexpected expression before int. Int is, okay, so something, rename it. What have we done here? Or maybe it also wants, what does it, oh dear, fd, so okay, fine. Men, what are the names of that are old dear fd and new dear fd, so int old dear fd. New dear fd, let's try this one more time. The problem is, so actually I have to say this add stuff, it even did something. Let's see if it even, the problem is, does it even freaking work? I have no idea. Actually, so it aborts only because I've actually modified the sources to hard abort, because otherwise it would not be an error. So this is hook add post make 5 abort. Which, fun fact, is even on camera. Just had fun with, so Andreas had fun with seccomp and Firefox Chromium. Yeah, sounds like fun. I also still, did we did this, okay, camera's still rolling. I hope by the way, audio's fine. Another fun fact, this enablement of using YouTube AdSense revenue to finance open source stuff only works if you share, like, and subscribe, so little shout out for that already. I actually don't remember if the SGA Octane error, actually I think it magically worked, the seccomp with OpenSSH, but anyway. So let's see, do we have this in the FL wrapper write log? And thank you very much, we don't. Cool, let's debug this further. It could still be that this this just hacked in there, rename it does not yet completely do what it's supposed to do. Let's maybe, I just before the YouTube live stream, okay, this is not in the show because I somehow killed it away. So what it's running is this here. And so this needs to create an entry in the write log. So that would be strace to look and follow all children. Let's see what we have in the log. For example, what rename at is doing. Rename. This is also not ideal, but anyway, let's touch the mktemp thing here and run this again so that it's guaranteed new. I also don't like this, but whatever, rename. Did we broke this entirely? Is that what is it doing? It's doing stat change mode add. Actually, it's also using, it probably should, by the way, so right now it's statting this. Is it not even, maybe it's, yeah, this also means a stupid install should install it in any case. Maybe we also need change mode add. Maybe we also don't have this. And what is the difference between F change mode and change permissions in file relative to the directory file descriptor? And does, why is it F change mode add and not, does change mode exist, or is it also, okay, anyway, maybe we also need this change mode. So somehow we are not logging change mode, which might not be ideal. I slightly wonder what is the stat at. Do we also need probably, strace touch A, was it is using open read F stat. F stat is get file status, and what is, should this not modify the, these functions return information about the file, except that the file will be stated is specified by the file descriptor fd. Exec access open f stat. Anyway, slightly wondering, should this not get file status relative? Slightly wonder. Let's try this here again. So the issue is also that ideal strace install this. So ideal also maybe, okay, this was with verbose. So issue is that even without rename, so I also don't like this, that this install is comparing this. I think this was here somewhere, compare. So the stupid install script is in comparing this. And so if you're bootstrapping this or if you're recompiling this, it's then even harder to debug, because if you reinstall it just in case, you certainly want this file installed as well. So for my case that I don't have this in the file modification log, it's not the most convenient that it's actually checking this. Also, I find this really hilarious. Instead of like install the thing, it's checking it if it's even different, but no. So the problem is, so it's setting this and then it's change mode. So we're not tracking change mode, but I slightly wonder, should we? Means theoretically change mode is changing the so the details of maintaining distribution and doing all the level stuff here at the frontier of level stuff. I still slightly wonder which I removed this. So then probably we maybe want at least change mode, but the issue is, the issue is also that it's not the most amazing that it's not reinstalling this. So rename. So we still get so far so good that probably hopefully our tracking still works. So we still have add current working directory, this temp file, current work. I mean, you see how it's like superfluous of like using this fancy system call. Like, I mean, basically the performance maybe is worse because of two additional parameters. I mean, worse performance as in a couple of machine clock cycles, but yeah. Anyway, so let's see if this gives us with the latest modification, this in our FL wrapper write log as in somehow still not or what? That is unexpected. Could there be any typo in rename at was it even rename at too many system calls? So wait a second, it's rename at 2. Why? That is what I remembered. Why is this rename at? Actually, okay, this is rename at and using the rename at 2 system call. Nah. I slightly wonder so. Somehow this obviously didn't work. Let's touch this again, rebuild this again. Let's watch for. So we also should eventually fix this. Warnings, obviously. But it doesn't give an immediate warning here. Let's maybe object dump disassemble this in build PowerPC 6432, probably tools cross toolchain. So rename, let's see. We have here rename at handle file access before and after. Why does this not yet work? I mean, we have here is that. Then we would need to debug that even more, unfortunately. I think it had some debug flag here in terms of debug. Oops. How often did I even have this open in some? I slightly wonder, how did this logic even work? How does this addWrapper function? So return type. Open. Special cased. Exec, everything else. Interesting fun stuff we've done there back in the day. So here's some logging. Let's try this again. Some excessive printfs. Stupid mouse wheel support. So let's install, maybe without strace we should get enough debug, oops, nah, scrolling stuff off. Here, just as an overview, how many, I probably should have logged this, what happens for the simple invocation of install something. As you've seen from strace in this debug log, pretty many. Okay, let's rm this again. And why don't we not have rename even in here? That was in, we could check the libc. Rename at that is clearly in there. Why would, I mean, we have this in the fl wrapper. Rename it. Why does this not work? What file would that be? That was rename it is from, what is the last? Some write of open read. I stress log. Ja. It's definitely not in there though. What unnecessary stuff just due to an even not needed system call. Why would this not work? Okay, which binary is it even? Stress log. So this should be the previous exec for ES in. Move. Okay, that makes sense. Let's see. What just running move already called so many. No, we have. Messed up our terminal. Let's try move touch A, move A, B. Somehow the terminal is messed up now. Here it works. Here is symbol rename in libc has been resolved. Going to run original rename. Why does this not work? Now it's on this stress log. Debug. Slightly wonder why do we have access in there? Complicated details. Anyway, just in case you were wondering why we don't have a new ISO yet, there's always something, also quite some people looking on this debugging failure, trying to understand what's going on and how this was working. Is this forwarding this wrong? I mean, this is of course slightly irritating now. Stress log. Rename. Oh, wait a second, don't tell me if we have we don't have run this with. Pause and follow, maybe. So I hate when the terminal acts up. Somehow the terminal is majorly messed up now. But why is this now not in the lock anymore? We don't know. Stress all F. Oh, wait a second. Also, just without this, actually, that explains the thing. Rename, it's in there. What does the stress look say? No, here's something in there. For whatever reason, it wasn't. Previously, we didn't have F for follow children. So, does this still look okay? Are we forwarding this correctly? Rename at 2 at. Also, yeah, probably they had a second version of rename it because probably the first they were not happy with the APIs because now Linux at. So this is correct. Current working directory A, current working directory this. Also, yeah, current working, yeah, I mean, absolute path, but yeah, amazing use of system calls. Anyway, so this is correct in there. Let's see if we have this now. In FL wrapper write log. Do we filter automatically something out? Not sure actually. But here's move rename. Or this is rename, but rename it. I slightly wonder, do we? Logs this with, oh, this was previously in there already. Let's try this with absolute parses because maybe we are actually removing temporary toolchain stuff for performance reasons. I remember something I had there, some maybe even I optimized this because building was bloody slow on other machines. So let's touch this again. Let's touch A. Let's S trace moving this to user bin, whatever A is okay. Let's maybe directly look into why is this not in there. So we locked this into there. Not in there? What the heck? How can this not be in there? Yeah, also, maybe with typo. Yeah. Okay, it's in there. So far, so good. Begin handling rename. Actually, do we automatically slightly wonder? Do we have some logic to remove at for some reason, maybe? Because it's obviously not showing rename at. Anyway, error log, or not error log. Or something is really going on with this tmux or whatever. So, okay, but this is in here now as a rename. let's strace log. Was this using it? Was using rename at 2. So far, so good. This might still not fix, so maybe this fixes half of, so it's just 10 minutes spent just verifying this stuff. Whatever's wrong with this. Let's maybe just test. So I'm still not entirely happy with this because I have the impression, well, in any case also we want to control C, hello, control C. We want to remove this debug thing because it obviously. Maybe over debugged already. So many typing glitches here. Yeah, this unfortunately means we can repeat here, even if this eventually works. Let's check the F list of mktemp. But as you see, the bloody bin thing. Okay, so the issue is, anyway, we have a second issue that is, it's not reinstalling this. Unfortunately, this is also entirely stupid var. ADM. So we have two issues. First of all, we can redo all the build anyway, because now we have many packages or nearly all without half of the files installed. That certainly isn't helpful. The second thing is we probably, but this is still not in here. Why is this? Are you freaking kidding me? Did I not, where is our, somewhere I, did I not move A somewhere? Okay, fine, whatever. Or was it bin? Oh, wait a second, maybe it was bin MK. What the heck? Did I not move this A somewhere? Anyway, whatever. It's still not in there though. Control C is also not working. So what is not actually not working anymore is Control C. Thank you very much for that. This is so stupid. Can we run Cinebench on the PS3 in the future? Only if you have a Cinebench PS PowerPC binary, which probably you don't have. Darn. What could possibly still. Yeah, you're welcome for P3 stuff, although this right now even applies to all our builds, because all the builds are broken then in this way, as in new system calls. Also, I hope this is in general for people to learn Linux internal stuff unrelated to PowerPC or the P3. Mktemp is in what? Also with dash name, obviously. And okay, right now it is there. Let's. Did I delete it there? I would hope so. Let's one more time, otherwise we really need to debug this further. But the unrelated stuff, this is not getting in there. Are you freaking kidding me? Why? Just running it like this and it doesn't work. Or is there a source destination? Maybe is rename it is. Is this maybe using. Is this maybe using the wrong pass as destination, source, so this is old your source, const char f. as we track this on what is named F or whatever. How could this still not work? I'm puzzled. We also don't track change mode, which probably also is not ideal. Welcome everyone, by the way, of this. Pisses me also somewhat off that Control-C doesn't work anymore here. Why is here it does work. What happened to this freaking key? You know what? We can just create a new terminal where Control-C works again. How could this still not work? So MKTimes, this is how it's running. Also ideal, as we have here multiple issues. Wait a second, what? It's not even getting there. What? But now it is there. What? Something is also I've somehow that also explains the thing. Somewhat it's too late today. Or something of so much to waste some extra 10 minutes for not deleting the right file. Also, we don't have this debug stuff right now anymore. As trace log, maybe I should have run this with debug. So, rename it. Do we log this or something is still not really working as it's supposed to be? There, Anthony, P3, appreciate all the work doing hard version work on Linux. Yeah, I wish, so the set thing is also this somewhat, it's hilarious. I spent so much time and now we have some new really stupid system call. I would slightly wonder since when, but probably latest call, utils version, I guess. Something is fishy with this rename stuff. Now it again doesn't work. Why would this? Rename it. Is there a new typo? What is here? The rename it. By the way, was it supposed to be? No, it wasn't supposed to be type. Can't make this fail up. It's hilarious. Oh, did I touch the wrong file now? But what is here the deal? But here it works. There must be something else that I'm overlooking. Begin of user bin A. Some very name. Why does this not happen with user bin M? Ktemp as trace. S trace install mktemp. Rename is clearly not in here. Why would this not be in there? Is this stuff somehow clearing the environment to some other crazy stuff? What are we even so rename? User bin mv. By the way, we have here the environment, so we still have exec wrapper stuff in here, thankfully to this excessive logging. By the way, with the fl wrapper. Stuff, it is in here. So then let's rename at search reverse for fl wrapper. And we have here really a lot of rights now though. Here's the rename. Execv is here. What is then opened? This is opened just after execving move. Object dump symbols of user bin move. Rename. Rename and rename at no other. Don't tell me this stuff can do the system call itself or some. Well, probably shouldn't be the case here. Yeah. What can be wrong with this stuff? It's definitely not in this log. Why would this not be? This is hilarious. Such an Heisenbug, I also have not debugged in a long time. It's used, but not in the log. Hmm. Something strange with symbol visibility. Here is. Move is clearly executed here a couple of times. Why would everything work except rename? What is next? Recompiling core utils with debug symbols and stepping through this bloody sources. We have anyway a twofold problem that even if I would fix this, rebuilding this doesn't recreate the file, unfortunately. Because doing this again doesn't even rename it. Yeah, rename is not in the log anymore. Instead, it's simply doing stud and change mod add. The problem is that it will not detect file access if it's not installed. Let's see, comments in the audience. Biggest hope for RSX emulation to look amazing on PS3. Always wanted 480p resolution with nice texture filtering. Which emulation are you looking for? Can't get Hashcat to work on cracking VPA handshake though. Can this be GPU lockdown related? Not really. Hashcat won't crack. So it managed to import poor PC lips. Yeah, not cool stuff. Just to document here what kind of crazy low level stuff one has to go through. Which system call is by the way used for updating this? Which also now we have all this spurious stuff. Because unrelated of the rename stuff, which really puzzles me though. What did I want to check? I wanted to double check whether mktemp. I wanted to double check which move is actually used for that. What? No move? What? All right. In this case, move is actually not used. Now, this is so stupid. Let's say do not even install it anyway. So yeah, which emulator are you looking for? What do you want to run there? And it's just a regular, why would this not track? Slightly wonder what was the business with this XXX thing. Somehow some abbreviated arguments, I guess. Don't even really remember after a decade. Slightly annoying, actually, this XXX. Wait a second. Why do we have here this was this? I hope this was not macro stuff. Can this be? What was the deal with this stuff? Probably was macro stuff. Okay, this is hard-coded and actually slightly irritating. I think I make this three dots because this is super annoying. Oops. What this should stand for means this ellipse is much more clearly signifies that there was potentially more stuff. Slightly wonder why we have not done it that way anyway. Why would this sometimes work but not always? This is so silly. What stupid stuff. Yeah, again, I wish we would do some amazing RSX stuff instead. We constantly need to keep our stuff working. And we have also another issue that not even reached yet. So yeah, this is much more professional and useful. Really wonder what we were thinking with the three axes. But it's reliably not in there. How can that be? I have no idea. Should we which version of move is this? 831. That was core utils 31. Replace, rename it. Adjust renaming of source move. Don't tell me they issue their own system core. What the heck is that? Because the issue is if it's not from the system library, we are not with this old-fashioned high performance. Shared library stuff, we are not tracking system calls. We actually have strays. We actually, this FL wrapper stuff is in a replacement of just strays, just running strays and everything is so much slower, like magnitude slower. Rename, replace, what is this doing? Traditional Linux values, wrapper of wrappers of, is this, I mean, it's so hilarious, they make such an effort. Somehow looks that this is a custom implementation of system call, rename it, that would explain why. What the garbage. But it has, wait a second, it has a rename at, rename r, rename at 2, no, okay. That explains why this is not, can't make this shit up. So the funniest thing is probably I recently accidentally, so thank you very much for that. So if you probably have the latest glibc, which I right now don't have here, you wouldn't even have this. Anyway, so then a couple of things. Let's commit this already, misc archive. Think it works in theory. Except here on this older system. Which we could also... So... also there's a white space. But in general, in my opinion, I mean, they implemented this optimization for something they don't really need, because usually they don't use, they use rename it with the same source and like current working directory stuff. And such an effort, in my opinion, this is a complete no-go to have custom system call implementation garbage there in your user space tools. But yeah, that is a Linux ecosystem. Let's fix this. White spacing there, and so here, edit, rename, add. Wait a second, does it mean that? But wait a second, does it mean that we need to wrap rename add to first? Okay, wait a second. Let's try something better fs. Let's snapshot this. By the way, better fs for reverse. Do I have right now a test snapshot? Better fs. Do I have? Create a snapshot. Better fs. Snapshot test. Creating snapshot. Let's do here something fancy. Do we currently have a reference build of toolchain packages? Glibc we have. And core utils, let's see, build reference log of 5 core utils rename add. Hey, this has a rename add and rename add too. Let's try if we can update our glibc, of course, because we are somewhat professionals, in a new test snapshot. Mine install verbose test glibc. What could possibly go wrong? Core utils. What? Why do I not have... Oh, okay, it didn't reveal. Okay, change root here. Okay, it's not yet crashing, though. We should have two ellipses now. So we are 2, 20, 2, 3, 4, 5, something. Yeah, let's try this live into our running system. If the stream ends now, then we have messed up our system with replacing the glibc. Maybe this even worked. So far, so good. User source, let's replace our core utils live here on this channel. Let's first rebuild it in reference. By the way, maybe I disable this again. Config package. Oops. Package. Ah, come on. It's not my typing day here. Package file create. Let's quickly build this reference. Job 5 core utils. Yeah, also creative use of BetterFS, certainly for package updates, certainly even better, fully automated. Yep, we can also speak German, but we usually don't do this because we want to reach 100,000 subscribers as soon as possible. Do we still have debugging on, or why is this? Oh, we have debugging on. Can't make this up. But if you want to ask something in German, then ask in German. But please not too much Russian. Paruski. Not too much, certainly not too fancy for questions here. Alien languages to me, this is an alien language, but like to check out from time to time which alien language. The reason we need to rebuild this is because for performance optimization, I usually run the reference testing build here of just testing all this fun stuff without creating the tarballs here, because usually I don't need them, so as much optimization to cut the build time down, the better. Where can I get T2 bootable ISO? So that is from a previous video. You can also click through there, which is here of DL. But the last one, it boots, but installation might, so this was binary 2019, installation might be one of the probably, or was this already even older than 2018? Time is running. Poor PC, smaller actually, was this already December? This one, maybe it's this one, smaller too, maybe. But that's also why we are here for, we can also sort this probably by maybe smaller, I don't really quite remember. It's linked on that below some video. Mine install this, but we are right now building the super latest and greatest, because the last one wouldn't install cleanly. So let's test this. Now we have the latest glibc, which also rename it to, don't tell me. At least it only has one. Why would it check for both? Not really. User include. It has here indeed rename it to. Can't make this stuff up, but not a man page. Rename file all, yeah, we know this already. Okay, GNU has, why do they have here old? Oh, this is a different order of, can't make this stuff up. Are you freaking kidding me? Are you with flex also? Flex garbage. Okay, so old, int and flex, fun stuff. Why does it have not a man page? Okay, fine, whatever. So that is why I didn't commit this yet. This also means we need rename it to here, because never can have too many variations of fancy system calls. So in case you were wondering if that is a thing, that is a thing. Rename old dear something stuff and flex. Let's try that again for Power PC. MKTemp, although this probably still actually doesn't fix the thing, also conflicting types for previous declaration, what does it want now, conflicting types for extern and previous declaration was int old why does it not say conflicting const char? That would be extern int const char int const f. Unfortunately, it doesn't show this in full. Int const char, unsigned int. Yeah. see if that works. Yes, theoretically, this also really gets a little bit on my nerves. Not really actually for this to check if it does something. We need to remove this, the case of not updating the file is an additional second thing. So yeah, working on an ISO, as you see, actually pretty annoying that so much stuff breaks faster than I can fix stuff. FL, that was mktemp. Hey, and we have user bin temp in there. The only issue is, okay, so far so good. We can finally commit this of this sort. White spacing 2020 copyright fun stuff. Professional, as you see, not only removed this stuff here, so this is in the new files 2 bytes shorter. And here this certainly looks much more amazing, this continuation ellipsis here than this bloody XX that even irritated me. So, edit, rename, and rename, add, and rename, add to FL wrapper, whatever. So, unfortunately, we now can also password for probably, let's see, do I not show that? And so unfortunately, due to at least, who knows how many other packages are affected. So yeah, it's some small glitch of not actually even installing it. It's there for another day. Also here, mktemp, but at least you probably learned that there is a rename and the add system calls and even rename too, because flex. And also that finding all these issues takes literally forever. Yeah, new ISO, I want a new ISO because the last one was not fully 100% finished in terms of not installing some file. Actually, I slightly wonder, is this a fluke, as in maybe it's simply also not in the F list here of, and then we can basically rebuild all of them, though. Or is this another issue? Well, this is actually in there, so why would it not find that then? Oh, wait a second. Maybe this is 64 versus, why does it still doesn't find the program for install? And but install is in there now. What the heck? Why is that now? libdl, so is this in there or not? Did I? No, it's supposed to be in there, or is it? Maybe as in, actually we waste a little bit of space now. We updated this, and it's also not ideal that when the ISO is a little bit larger than that happens with this, you continue a build, and then in the meantime we already V or data updated some packages. Actually, this could, no, this, why would it even, we should, we're supposed to, this is slightly funny, we're supposed to default to 32-bit user space, at least I sort. Sorry, so sorry, so these are all 32. Target gen shared in probably time. to go home then. So here's here libc, and oops, I slightly wonder if this is related to. So multiplexer allows such hex, so this should actually be that, but actually, very theoretically, maybe we probably don't need the other one anyway. So maybe we make this if this otherwise. Actually, wait a second. Because it's optimizing this even a little bit further. Your spaces here. Optimizing this further, we could actually include this here so that we don't waste time we don't waste space with a 64-bit variant. So if we default to that, then that probably could save a couple of megabyte, unrelated of the issue that right now the file is not there to start with anyway. As you ask for an ISO, I answered this already. However, now we have this issue here. So there clearly is still something going on in imperfection, but this is exactly there. I think there is no other ISO except T2 most likely. So something newer than red, what was this, red ribbon, whatever stuff, which in any case I wouldn't trust because who puts this together? Untrustworthy sources of unpublished stuff. But see, by the way, this preparing is also shouldn't be there, right? Also not with SVN. So what's going on there? PowerPC 64, 32, toolchain, second stage stuff of disks. And what do we have in here? We have lib, or is this building some stuff? So we have here LD, do we have it, or oops, do we really not have this LD in there? What the heck, why? Or it could also see, wait a second, we really don't have the glibc in here right now. Anyway, we anyway need to rebuild this. I really wonder why though. Why would this? But in any case, I need to rebuild it anyway because due to this use of rename at now in this bloody new core utils version for no good reason whatsoever, we now miss all the packages in there anyway. And so probably I just rebuild this here, leave this running, go home, finally get dinner, and rebuild this from scratch, because not only are many packages missing some random files of stupid move rename reasons, but the glibc that is right now not unpacking for whatever reason is anyway, even if it would unpack, by the way, did I copy this? Even if it would unpack, we would have two versions, so wasting a bit of space. So yeah, probably clean this build, I guess, and fix some issues, clean up some stuff. And why does this not clean? Clean up also build rest with L. But yeah, probably you don't want to have a Sun membrane keyboard of this sort. Build PowerPC, so yeah, that's probably, now it's gone. Let's config this. So I leave this running and give you an update as soon as we have an update. And generic, what did I wanted to check? So 32-bit default, very theoretically, oh wait a second, optimization, we could, I think it should actually run if we optimize for G5. I think there's not a reason not to optimize for G5. I think this was fully compatible. Very theoretically, we could even, I think it should work. I'm only concerned that it still boots on my G5 for testing purposes. Maybe we'll leave it for G5 anyway. Maybe cell optimization for the not as amazing speculative in order pipelines of the cell. But yeah, what else do we have? Size vectorization, no debug symbols. Our tempf is certainly we want to enable. And yeah, on the AMD machine here, this will not take too long. It's a pity that we wasted this one build. But anyway, yeah, we anyway have to have this move stuff fixed. And whatever's going on, this might either be, I remember I tweaked there some things with some details with the dynamic loading stuff that we broke this once a little bit with Musel, our Musel LLVM ceiling build stuff, previous videos. And then we fixed this again. So maybe there's still something broken. We will see. But anyway, see you soon. Thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in. I hope you learned something. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe as usual. And yeah, stuff is coming. But also, you can certainly help. I said this before. Not only do we have this data bot, which, fun fact, today also committed some updates. But unrelated of this, of course, you can help by simply sending in some patches. So yeah, data here at work of this amazing updates. The last days, why are I done? I need to also a new SSL certificate doesn't update right now. But anyway, some data updates from data every other day, and otherwise, yeah. If you want to help, send some patches in, and yeah, we are getting there. It's of course hilarious. Each time we are finally made some progress and think we can spin it, there's always some major breakage of can't even make this stuff up. Core utils, not only new system calls for, yeah, okay, the recurring stuff, but yeah, just also a testament of how much time it takes to look into this stuff, debugging it, adding support, testing support, debugging support, and then people like embedded customers tell me, yeah, and this stuff needs to work. If it doesn't work, we can't use it. And if it works, then yeah, either way, they don't want to pay for something. So yeah. Thanks that you share, like, and subscribe, financing all this stuff. Otherwise, Patreon for you if you want to have a plain vanilla raw like sushi Linux distribution. And yeah, update soon. But yeah, I also wish the problem is so much maintenance time. Although we need it, as I said, we need it for all the x86 MIPS and any other build anyway. But yeah, it's a pity that so much time is going away or is used for this generic toolchain stuff and we're not playing with the RSX. But yeah, we're getting there. Also, previous video. By the way, before this video, I finished here this amazing FPGA Ulix 3S. FPGA stuff. So now we have probably I can even power it on, can I, whatever, gets the idea. Stream is long enough. Also, why do we have, darn, it was so amazing. Now we have so many drop frames. Can't make this 14, are you freaking kidding me? 10%, I thought Vodafone cable garbage docs has fixed this. Not zero drop frames the last days. I didn't know. Yeah. Anyway, hope to see you soon for the next videos and live streams to come.